Well, I think during the 80s in South Africa, it was the time of apartheid. It was a time of gender and racial repression.
In what way gender repression?
Well, I don't think gay people had a voice, did they? It was only during, you know, the new regime, the Baker regime, really, where gay people...
With the new constitution.
The new constitution.
Very progressive.
The progressive, you know, equity sense that people had a voice. Of course, it's only on paper. We know in practice it could also mean something else. I think gay people know that as well.
Don't you think that gay people in South Africa is a very important and constitutive part of this organization of civil society?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, if you look at people who were very much part of the liberation of South Africa, and that should never be negated. But I'm speaking pre-1994. I'm speaking about the heydays of apartheid when...
Was it illegal to be gay?
Well, I think...
For men, certain sexual actions were illegal.
Illegal, but, yeah. I mean, people, you know, had to pay a price if they wrote, you know, the kind of text we published. I mean, people took a stand against us. I can remember as a young lecturer, I was called in by the dean because I had the gumption, the chutzpah, to say in an interview that I'm not only writing gay poetry, but that I'm also gay.